Welcome to the last lecture. Chapter 1, The Lion Still Wants to Roar. I think what my spirit animal is a meerkat, because some characteristics of a meerkat is just like me, you know? Like, they're very much different than other animals in the world. They usually stay with their family for like most of their life and like help each other out. Even though once down, they have their whole family just to take them up. Well, for right now, I'm still in my house and my family, but yeah, it's something like that. We help each other and butt each other up when one is fallen. Yeah, I live with my parents, my sister. We all live in the same house for our whole life. Now we always stick together. Like I said before, when one goes down, the other three helps them up. We can talk almost anything with each other, even from awkward stuff to serious stuff about someone, something, or about us. So yeah, I think this America is just like me. You know, I think it's my spirit animal. Most importantly, the meerkats really have teamwork with their family, you know? They stick together and help each other out. Chapter 2, The Parent Lottery. Like what I said before, I live with my two parents. They are Kevin Nguyen, Hannah Nguyen. And they are my parents. They helped me through anything from the start when I was born to present day. And also, I live with my sister, Joyce Nguyen. She could be a little annoying, just like any other siblings. So that's only my house family, and I have a more extended family. They live all over the United States. I have two grandpa, two grandmas, but this picture is from my mom's side. She has five different sisters and one younger brother. And so all the sisters are all married. They all have kids. They have 2 to 3 kids to take care of. That's a lot of cousins I have. But my uncle is still looking for family, but not yet. He's still in school, trying to finish school, get a good job. And I'm the oldest cousins in the family, and everybody else is younger. It goes for me, my sister, and other ones. And we have one big family. My parents and one of my uncles and my mom's younger brother all influenced me to do stuff I wanted to do. They never stopped me to do what I didn't want to do. They pushed me to where I need to be right now in basketball and school. They helped me get through all the stuff. They basically been with me from the start and still are with me to now. They all helped me get better in what I need to get better in. Also, to push me to never give up to my dreams. Chapter 3, I Never Made It to the NFL. Right now, I play in a sport called basketball. And badminton, I've been through many basketball coaches that coached me throughout the years. I've been playing. Only like a couple stood out. Those ones only like disciplined me, showed like life lessons. They've been showing me the world of adulthood, well, kind of. They disciplined me. They showed me how to act and be with other people. So yeah, there's only a couple of them after like the millions, or not millions, but like tens. Yeah, they're. Only a couple of them were showing me the way of being the person I am today. You know. Without those few, I wouldn't be the person I am today. The one is being like I try to be as kind as possible to others, but I wouldn't be like that without those coaches. Chapter 4. Happiest place on earth. I would say the happiest place I have on earth is my house, and in the house is my room where I could get to every day, where I could sleep every day, wake up to every day, where I have almost all the stuff I own every day. You know, I can do almost anything in my room, or even though I'm having a bad day, I have something to get on, like my bed, to rest, you know. Have my clothes to wear, have my phone to charge, my computer to charge, so I can use in the later days, and I can have a place to be quiet where I can do my homework. So yeah, I'll see my room in my house. A second place that I consider my happy place is my church, you know, where I have friends at church where I can hang out, you know, just relax with each other, have fun, have some laughs, play some games, fellowship, and yeah, where I could relax. J, chapter 5. The two people on earth that keeps me on task and keeps me together, which are my parents. They help me get through whatever I need to do, what I need to do, and they show me how to get through stuff that I need to get through. They're there when I need them, when I'm down, when I'm up, I'm happy, sad, angry. They're there just to support me and just be there, you know. And that also goes well as my second person, which is God, you know. He's there whenever I need him. You know, he doesn't talk back to us in his way, but he's just there to be there for me. He's the one who's telling me what to do, planning everything else what I need to do, having me to do stuff he wants me to do under his name. Chapter 6, Recovering Jerk. When I was young, I used to be a little bully, you know, one of those little 3, 4, 5, 6-year-old bully who tries to have fun with their friends, but sometimes it doesn't go the way they think it is. Either me using not the correct words, or not doing the correct actions, and hurting their feelings because he doesn't know the boundaries. Do you know how sensitive my friends are? So I used to make people cry in elementary, try to get friends, you know, how to have some fun with them. But it doesn't go that way because I don't know how to react, you know. Just be playful. But years came on, I gained some knowledge, some wisdom, following mentors, which got me to where I am today, you know. Just constantly learning, you know, gaining wisdom. Most wisdom I learned is from my pastor, who constantly teaches me the word. Big Dream, Chapter 7. So I dream of big things, like being in the NBA, you know, like most know. So I kind of have that dream, but my parents have a different opinion about me, just trying to be something different, not being in the NBA. You know, maybe be like a doctor, someone smart, engineer, like my dad. You know, they try to convince me through stuff. They ask other people to convince me. I don't know if they ask, but like, other people do come up to me and ask me, what do you want to be? Why do you want to be it? And they give me their opinion of it, what I should be. But we think differently, you know. We have our own opinions. So that's why they have different sayings of each other. You know, I want to be one thing, they want me to be another thing, try to make me something different because they live in a different world. A world with no technology, or not as much as we do, you know. I think that's one of the reasons why I have different opinions. Chapter 8, Never Give Up. Some goals I set myself from now to the future is being in the NBA. What I said before, where I constantly just practice and practice, just get better and better every day. And I'll learn how to play the game much better, you know. Probably get a higher level than other people, or just to be better. Mindset that I have while training or practicing is to say to myself that let's do this and that just to get this and that, or let's do this and that just to get better, you know. Just try my best, and hopefully we'll pay off in the future. A second goal that I made myself is getting better to school, just by studying and telling me that if you do this, I'll get this, but sometimes it doesn't go that way. So then I told myself just to do it again and again and again until you get it and what deserve it. I have help from my friends who are with me from the beginning and are still here present. And I could keep going with my friends and have trust and faith in God that I will not stop. My third goal is to learn more about God and have more trust in God. As a little Christian boy who's still learning and walking with God, I tend to misjudge God, you know, as I am still learning who I am. And I kind of try to pray and read more the Bible and pray to God more, you know, as a Christian would do, just to put more trust and faith in Him. Chapter 9, Tigger or Eeyore? I'll say I'm more of a Tigger because I'm like a happier guy, or more happier than the people I hang out with around me. I tend to have a mindset to be more positive and be more playful with my other people who are always negative and sad and always depressing. They don't look on the happy side and they say that life sucks, but I say life's good because I have a positive attitude. And I kind of have my head up most of the time, just have fun, look to have fun with my friends around me. I tend to be the fun one in the group that's really easy to have fun, have the most energy. Chapter 10, The Dreams Will Come to You. From being a little boy in elementary school into being a big strong kid playing basketball and hoping to be nice and a Christian boy, it's pretty hard. It takes time to gain wisdom from other people. it's pretty hard. Just to surround yourself with good and positive people. Learning from the most positive mentors, who's always happy, who's always productive in what they do. Just have a mindset just to learn from other people and being. And soon being a role model for little kids. And yeah, just being there, just learning, turn my life around to where I am today, having the benefits from my mentors and putting them into action with other people and working out, having good friends, which is really a good big turnaround from being a little bully. I wanna leave off here by just saying, just don't stop grinding whatever you're grinding. Just keep going whatever you're going for. Don't let anybody stop you. Next is just don't be sad. You know, just have a positive mind. Wake up with a positive mind. It will help you a lot. You know, just be happy. And lastly, just have faith. Have hope. In everything you do, even though it doesn't seem possible, just have hope. You know, you get past whatever you're doing with just hope. And just believe that you'll finish it. And I want to leave off this video with that. I'll say thank you for watching this video. It took me a while to just draw, edit, put together photos, find photos, and for this video to work. And yeah, end off with saying never give up, never stop grinding, just be happy, and yeah, and love God. Thank you.